Hey everyone, I'm Duke. Welcome to the Binding of Isaac Rebirth, version 1.01. The patch just came out about an hour ago, which I'm pretty excited about. A lot of people have had some serious issues with this game, not being able to start the game at all, the game crashing randomly, all of their saves randomly being deleted. My only issue that I was having before the patch was that my other files would not save. File 1 was the only file I could save on, which was kind of a bummer because I went to keep file 1 pristine. This is my streaming file, so anytime I'm streaming this game or just recording videos of it, it'll be a direct continuation of the stream that came before it. I'll move the mic back. Am I too loud? Sorry. Oh, I know what the problem is. Hang on. I was testing the different modes on my mic the other day because me and Moores were in the same room, and I had the switch changed to room mode instead of cardioid mode. Hopefully I should sound a little better. I might also have to fiddle with the gain knob a little bit because I messed around with that. So anyway, file 2 is now my just messing around, not streaming save. Is it better since I switched over, or can you still hear me breathe, or what's the deal? Okay, Sarah the Lich, what's up? So yeah, I actually made quite a bit of progress on these files. File 2 didn't work at all. File 3 saved, but it kept randomly wiping out the data. And even when I backed up my save folder, it didn't seem to help. Like, when I went to restore my backup, file 3 was still missing. So I guess it was a problem with, like, the Steam Cloud save synchronization or something like that. I don't know. Anyway, hopefully I sound better now. And let's go ahead and continue with file 1. And, we don't have a winning streak currently because, unfortunately, on the last run we made it to Satan, Moores and I did, and I'm still squelching out. Okay, let me adjust the gain a little bit. Sorry, I totally forgot I was messing around with this mic. Because when Moores and I streamed, I ended up not using this mic at all. He brought his mic, and we just both hooked into my mixer, and we did it that way. So, yeah, I should have messed with this mic, tested it before I started streaming. I apologize. Anyway, let's get the show on the road. So who do I have unlocked on the save? Kane, Maggie, and this guy, Lazarus. I never did figure out what the deal with Lazarus is. I have 2 Eden tokens, so I guess I might as well go ahead and try out this character. Someone mentioned that this is another character that doesn't have actual hearts. It's better now. Awesome, thanks. This character has soul hearts, at least according to what someone was saying. So this should be a challenging run. But I have to at least try him, her, it out. Okay, so I start with the unicorn horn. That's cool. And my character looks pretty cool. It's a badass cloak. I'd appreciate it if you didn't just drop. I mean, I haven't messed with this character at all, so I kind of like to, discover the good things and the bad things about the character myself. I have 2 soul hearts and 3 doom hearts, which is the term I coined for the hearts that blow everything up when you get hit. Oh, it isn't a him or a her. Okay. Well, if that's a spoiler, I don't really consider that a spoiler. That's just, lore information. I mean, all the other characters are characters from the Bible. And Eden is not a character, it's a place. So I guess that makes sense that the character isn't a him or a her. I guess it's like the anthropomorphized version of the Garden of Eden. Yeah, because Eden existed before Adam and Eve. If I'm looking for a pattern, I'm not going to find one. Okay, I will keep that in mind. Go ahead and use the Hierophant because that just gives me soul hearts. Okay. Fat Protector. Oh. So it's just a chubby little fly that kind of circles around me. That's cool. That's an item I have not seen yet. Yeah, Bible stuff. I've never actually read the whole Bible. Which I guess makes me a... Look at how my character flashes when I stand on the spider web. That's weird. I guess it's just a visual indication of being slowed down. But I never really noticed it before. Maybe it's more noticeable with the cloak. Because it's really dark. Yes, it protects my fat. Oh, hey. It's one of the horse persons of the apocalypse. So there's another item you can get from the horseman in Rebirth. I haven't fought the horseman yet, but I watched a stream where someone got a ball of bandages for beating one of these horse people. And, I mean, it makes sense because, you know, the characters from Super Meat Boy are Meat Boy and Bandage Girl. Those are like the two, the two titular characters of the game almost. So I haven't seen like what happens if you collect multiple balls of bandages. If like Bandage Girl is someone who walks around, or you know, is similar to Meat Boy, or you know what the deal with her is. Oh, you know what, man, I've been talking about like trying to find the Book of Revelations. It didn't even occur to me that it wouldn't have been unlocked yet. But yeah, that makes sense. You have to fight the horseman before you have access to the book. All right, I have no bombs or keys, so I cannot blow up the X block or go into the item shop. Oh, I totally forgot about my unicorn horn, but I still did okay. So I guess I just might as well get out of here. Level 2 Meat Boy except pink with a bow. Okay. So I wonder if it would be possible to get both Meat Boy and Bandage Girl running around. I mean, probably not, because the only way you can get cubes of meat is by fighting the horsemen, and there's a limited number of those. So I guess Bandage Girl was probably just like a reskin for Meat Boy, really. I have to say, I like my little halo of items here. I mean, it doesn't move fast, but the side of me that the items are on is very well protected. So yeah, I still haven't had a successful Satan run. I had a couple runs where I made it to Satan when I was playing off stream, but I have not been able to defeat him yet. Oh, and since I don't have any actual heart hearts, just soul hearts and doom hearts, this challenge room is open. Let's see, this would give me health. But, you know, I haven't taken any damage yet. So I'm going to wait, and if I still haven't taken damage by the end of the level, then I'll leave without picking that up. But if I do end up taking damage, I'll go back for that. Because I don't want to have, like, you know, a boss rush or a mini boss rush if I had the possibility of getting Basement Boy here. You can rarely reroll items into cubes of meat in the original Isaac. Yeah, that's true. That's another way you can get cubes of meat. Man, still no bombs. I'm seeing these X-blocks everywhere. So yeah, I don't want to jinx my chances of getting Basement Boy. But now that I mentioned it, it's too late. Can't take it back now. Right, if I can kill this boss without taking damage, which shouldn't be impossible, then I'm just going to leave without getting the lard. Because I don't want to mess up my chances of getting Basement Boy. Item button, it's this one, right. Nice! Oh! I already got the achievement. I don't even have to leave the level. I forgot about that. I just have to beat the boss. Okay, cool. So I can go back for that now. Let's see if Satan has anything worth getting. Well, that would take all of my actual real hearts, so I think I will leave that alone for now. My unicorn horn is OP now? Is it like more powerful than the normal unicorn horn with this character? Or do you mean it's just OP in Rebirth in general? Did seem pretty powerful. Oh wait. Oh, I guess there was a room I haven't gone into yet. Pretty excited about getting Basement Boy. That took me forever in the original Binding of Isaac. And it was the only no damage achievement I got. I never got the one for the caves, or the depths, or the womb. I didn't even get the item room. Wow. I was all set to leave. That would have been quite a mistake. Temporary buddy generator. Don't know if it's better than the horn or not. Well, let's at least see what it looks like. Oh, okay, it just gives me a temporary familiar. Yeah, I think I'd rather have the horn. Still no bombs. I guess I could use my key and see if there's a bomb for sale. But I kind of like to hold on to it. Yeah, I agree, just drop. Oh wait, I can't go in here now because I actually have hearts. Ha! How ironic. Oh well. I mean, I could give them to Satan to get whatever that item is, and then I could also go into the boss challenge. Oh wait, no, Satan's gone. Missed my chance. Oh well, I'm out. Yeah, one room familiar, and it takes four rooms to recharge. I unlocked Samson. I forget what the unlocking requirement for Samson is in this one. In the original, you just have to pass up on two item rooms. I guess it has something to do with not taking any damage. Alright, let's see if I can keep my no-hit streak going and get the Cave Boy achievement as well. That would be a first for me. I did not get that in the original. Of course, I'm not going to be too careful. I mean, I'm still going to explore all of this level. And, I'm not going to take any... Oh, too close to that fly. Oh, well. At least I got it over with, and I don't have to worry about it. Man, trying to do anything perfectly is just really stressful. Oh, dead bird. It's that thing that Eve has, or at least the thing that she had in the original, where she gets hit, it pops out, and... flies around damaging enemies. It's okay. It's one of those items that only does something when you get hit, and I don't like those in general. I mean, it's better than not having it, obviously. But, like, if I have an activated item or something that does damage to me, I'm probably not going to use it. Wait. Oh, I guess I had a pill that I forgot to use. Okay, well, let's see what yellow does. Pheromones. Still haven't actually used that when there were enemies around. I haven't seen what the charm ability does. Alright. And white pills. Okay, this one's really weird. Because, like, it takes hearts from you, but it makes hearts... materialize around you. Like if I had four hearts in a different run, I had many, many hearts, and when I use that pill, it takes four from me and it spawns four around me. So I guess since I only had two hearts, it couldn't do that, so it took one and it spawned three. Not really sure what the formula is there. I don't want to use my key on the item shop. Oh, when you get increased damage, it counts towards your activated items as well? Interesting. Didn't really look at my stats or anything. On the character select screen, all of the stats are were question marks. So I don't know. I don't know if it's like different every time or what. Takes half your red heart's HP and turns it into more HP. Good for blood banks. So, well, that's that would be useful in certain situations. Whoa. Hey, lucky poop. I'll take it. Oh god. Shit. Oh. Damn. That big fly is pretty helpful when it's in the right position. Alright, so there are two locked doors. So one of them's the shop, the other one's something else. I have three keys, so I can open both of them and still be able to open the item room on the next floor. So I'll go ahead and do that. Well, not gonna buy any of that just yet. Oh, you got burnout on the game already? Just right, that sucks. The Hermit. That takes you to the item shop, right? Yeah, I think so. Judgment, that's the bomb, I think. Moon, that takes you to the secret room. Oh, another moon. Well, let's go ahead and go to the secret room. Aw, man, really? That's it? Man, so far the secret rooms in this game have been super disappointing. I haven't found any like 1-up mushrooms in them or any of the cool stuff I always used to find. Alright, well, let's go back to the tarot card room. Do I want to use this guy? I kind of want to save my money. Well, I already unlocked Kane, so I guess there's really no reason to, What happened to my cloak? I just now noticed that it's gone. I guess it got rid of it so you can see the dead bird on my head. But you can see my spiky head a lot better now as well. Yeah, I'll just go ahead and take the moon with me. Hang on to my money. Oh, you need to unlock shit for them to be worth it? Yeah, that could be the case. Alright, so what I should do is I should use my unicorn horn on the boss. Well, no, I guess it wouldn't be that big of a deal to recharge my horn quickly. No point in going back to the shop just for that. Alright, here we go. Ooh. Two widows. Oh, crap. That's bad news. Good thing I have this little buddy. Does seem quite a bit OP. I can't tell if it's more OP than the original or not. I figure it probably is. Tears and shot speed up. Nice. Oh hey, my cloak's back. Good. Oh, because my bird's flying around, it's not on my head anymore. That's cool. It's like an adaptable cloak. And now that's back on my head, my cloak's gone. It's like a cloak of invisibility, except that the thing that becomes invisible is the cloak. Alright, yeah, I'm not going back to the item shop. I'm done. I'm out of here. I'm still enjoying this game quite a bit. Like, even losing all my progress on my other saves, which was a bummer, I'm still really excited to play more of it. I guess I haven't played that much. I've only put like 8 or 9 hours into it since the game came out, which I mean, you know, that's a good chunk, but it's not like I'm playing 12 hours a day or anything. Arcade. Oh shit. I think I'll just hang on to my money. Oh, 17 hours just right. Well, I can see why you're burned out on it then. That's quite a lot for, what is it, 3 days now? Well, I guess almost 4. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. I mean, I'm still, you know, I'm still pretty excited to discover the rest of the stuff I haven't seen. See all the new content. Because there's a lot of new stuff. Oh yeah, I saw this moon card. I should just go ahead and use that. Well, poop. Nah, that could have been worse. Champion enemies don't drop consumables regularly. You mean like cards and pills? Yeah, you may be right. Come on, Lucky Poop. You're supposed to make those poop piles better. Get with the program. Oh god. All right. They located the second secret room for me. Thank you. Whatever you are. Ooh. Okay, so this door is going to stay open, right? That's one improvement that I definitely like about this version, is that once you bomb open a secret passage, it stays that way. You don't have to waste another bomb getting back into it. Oh, like any items? Yeah. I don't know. I mean, I've seen them drop coins and stuff pretty regularly. I'm not sure. Piggy bank. That's interesting. I have no idea what that does. My life savings. Alright, well, maybe coins give me more money now or something? I'm not sure. Health down? No! I already have so little health to begin with. That's exactly what I needed. Hey, Mr. Shade, what's up? Yeah, it does tend to be a little emptier when I don't announce the streams well ahead of time. But it's okay. I'm happy just have you guys hanging out. All right, let's go down here since I haven't been in this room yet. Oh god. Now I know why I didn't go down that way. Oh, hey. Item room, nice. Ooh, holy water. Not the best item in the world, but at least it's, you know, at least it doesn't take up a slot, an item slot or anything. Oh, you're playing on hard, that's right, yeah. That could be affecting it as well. Yeah, co-op Isaac is a lot of fun. Like, I was a little worried it would be no fun for the second player. But, when Morz and I played, we both had a really good time with it. I think they found just the right balance of letting the second player do shit without without overpowering or, you know, unbalancing the game. It was a pretty disappointing chest, to be honest. Was it like a net of one key and a heart? Definitely not what I expect from a from this kind of challenge room. Shit. Oh, there goes the holy water. Man, it's two items I have that only do stuff when you get hit. It's like the game is giving me ironic punishment for talking shit about those items. Phew. Hey, at least you can see my badass cloak now. Now that I got hit. I wonder if the cloak was designed with those holes that the spikes can poke out of, or if the spikes just kind of, you know, work their way through the material. Golden chest almost always worth opening. Yeah, I mean, that one was worth opening. It was, you know, it replaced the key I used and gave me an extra one. It's just, for a boss challenge room, you know, I'd like an actual, like, pickup item. Are we streaming Borderlands just dropped? I wasn't sure if you guys wanted to stream that. The last time I streamed Borderlands 2, it did not seem to be very popular. Oh, god damn it. These spiders are really hard to see now. I mean, I really like the cool room lighting effects and stuff, but like when it's dark like this, spiders are not as visible as I would like them to be. Or I could just be blaming something besides my own lack of skill. It could be the case. Man, that piggy bank must be giving me money from something, because I have way more money than I thought I've been picking up. Is there anything else in the shop I want to buy? No, just a bomb. Okay, I'll leave that there. I mean, it's up to you guys. We can stream it if you want to. Alright, I'm gonna leave that there until after I beat the boss. Do I want to go to the arcade? I might as well at least see what's in the arcade, now that I have all this money. Oh god. Because, you know, sometimes there's items and stuff laying around in the arcade. Might be worth it. Blood bank and both kinds of slot machine. Well, actually, I want to test something. I kind of want to see, because I haven't really been paying attention when I've been picking up money. I want to see if it's worth more or something. If I can get it to give me any money. Well, I guess the easiest way to get money is to hit that. Alright, so I have 11, now I have 12, okay. Huh, so I'm not sure where all that money came from, to be honest. I mean, I got the gold poop, but I didn't think it was that much. Hey, what's up, Lord Tamar? The little masks of infamy and the guys who throw bones. Yeah, the guys who throw bones aren't terrible, unless you're in, like, a confined room with them. Like, if you don't have a lot of space to maneuver, then yeah, the bone throwers are a huge, huge pain. Alright. Oh yeah, that's right. I forgot the blood machine ignores your soul hearts and only takes actual hearts. So what I could do is I could hit the blood machine, get half a heart, go back to the blood machine, get half a heart, and do that ad nauseum. But that would just take entirely too much time for a stream. So, I'm just gonna... Oh yeah, I haven't fought the boss yet. It's kind of kind of an important stat. Oh no! I used it right before I jumped. How unfortunate. Boss isn't too tough. I mean, that attack is kind of scary, but as long as you look at the shadows, it's pretty easy to figure out where you need to stand. Shot speed and damage. Alright, wow, my damage is getting pretty good. Alright, so let's go in here. Ooh, that's the thing that gives me wings, right? Oh yeah. Unkillable fire. Yes! Flight and hit points up. Wow. Nice. Excellent. Alright. Let's go back for that soul heart. Or eternal heart, rather. Has a donation machine been figured out? Well, sort of. I mean, I haven't donated a ton of money to it, but, well, here. I'll go ahead and show that off now. Since I have all this money. Oh, wait. It broke as soon as I put a penny into it. Basically, when you put a certain amount of money into it, at certain levels, it unlocks new items you can get, and it levels up the shop. And I don't know what leveling up the shop actually does yet, and I'm really looking forward to seeing what that looks like. Because I think it's 20 coins gets you the level 1 shop upgrade, or maybe it's 25. And I'm assuming if there's a level 1, there must at least be a level 2, so who knows how high that goes. Oh yeah, I could have used my unicorn horn on the blood machine. Oh well. I would. Oh yeah, flight. Ha ha ha! Spikes are of no worry to me now. Oh shit. Well, these guys are still of worry, but damn it, not as much worry. Should have killed the guy on the left first, but oh well. Oh, you couldn't tell the difference between the shops. That sucks. I was hoping there would be like more items available for sale or something. Well, I have 5 keys, but I'm not quite at the level where I'd like to give keys to that guy yet. Hey! I killed that guy. You were supposed to die. Well, I'm taking some damage. Yeah, at 20 coins with the donation machine, it unlocks something called the blue map. And I'm not sure what that is yet. Oh, oops. Oh well. Dang it. Well, this would be a pain in the ass if I couldn't fly. I guess. What the hell? What just. I don't know what hit me. Did they shoot a projectile at me? I like this enemy because it just sits there and does nothing. At least if it does something, I haven't figured out what it is yet. It's a pretty good enemy to get though. Well, this would be an annoying room if I couldn't fly. Hello, weird gray Larry Jr. Damn, I don't know where this money is coming from. I just looked up and I have 24 all of a sudden. That is strange. Maybe it just goes up. Like, after I clear a room or something? I guess I'm like accruing interest or something. Alright, so it's 24. I'm gonna pay attention and see if anything happens after I clear this room. Alright, it definitely doesn't make those more valuable. I've determined that. Alright, 26. Alright, I clear the room and it's still 26, so I'm not sure. Toxic splash damage. Whoa! I like the look of my tears. Oh, every time I take damage, Okay. I guess I've just been so fixated on trying not to take damage that I haven't noticed that. So it's yet another item that I have to take damage for it to do any good. Oh well. This doesn't seem to be poisoning them or anything. Weird. Can't tell if that splash damage is actually doing anything. Alright, so I can go down to the challenge room if I want. Well, let's go in here since I have all this money. I suppose I'll buy that. Not worth getting the deck of cards since I still have the unicorn horn. It's a good starting item. I wonder if Eden always starts with that. It's just a chest. I'm not gonna mess with that. Alright, is this Mom's Heart yet? I forget if this is one or two. Nope, just one. Okay. Ow. Yeah, it is spawning money, isn't it? I totally did not notice that. Shit! Damn it! Oh, I took way too much damage there. Whoa. Giant pill. Speed up and so- Oh yeah! I got this when Morz and I were playing. An enemy walks on the splatter and takes damage. Oh, you mean the holy water? Yeah, I know about that. Well, that's a good room. Or are you talking about something else? Meh. I wish I could throw more of this money into the donation machine. Oh, the toxic shots. Oh, I see. I guess it only... Well, yeah, there's a little bit of a splatter there. I guess the big splatter only happens when you hit an actual enemy with it. Did you know you can kill these guys? I got an item earlier that actually killed this guy when he dropped a couple coins. It was really weird. I'm not sure how many items have that capability. Alright, I have 8 bombs. I guess I could look for secrets. There are really only a couple spots where it seems like they would obviously be. Well, not there. I don't think the item room can ever spawn, or the secret room can ever spawn in a spot where it's bordered by a room where that wall is inaccessible. I think the game's smart enough not to let that happen. Not 100% sure, though. Like here, I really doubt the secret room will be here, because there would be no way to get to it under normal circumstances. Oh, you can blow them up with bombs. I guess I just never tried that. Nice. Oh, okay, well. I see, yeah. Okay, there's a much bigger splatter when you actually hit an enemy with it. Ah, oh, fuck's sake. So, like, this room... Whoa. Wait. Huh. So, like, if there was a gap here, then the secret room couldn't be here. At least I think that's the way it works. I don't think it ever spawns the secret room in a spot where that can happen. Alright. Speed up, nice. Pretty fly, nice. More orbitals, always welcome. And bad trip. Okay. Well, I guess that was worth it overall. One more. I want to save one key for the item room on the next level. Okay, well, that should be giving me more keys, but I still want to save this one. Wish I had more health. I lost all those soul hearts I got from the angel room. Well, not really. I lost half of them, but still. Oh, for a second I thought that was the boss room. I was like, already? Oh, it's one of these. Okay. Well, let's... Oh, my unicorn horn still wasn't charged. Well, I guess let's just throw all my money into this guy, see what I get. Or most of my money. Hey, nice. That might come in handy. The devil. Nice. All right, I don't want to mess with either of you guys, so, Oh, wrong button. Alright, let's hang on to... Well, I guess let's go ahead and use this, actually. I think that's a good mushroom. I don't remember. Damage up. I think there's a similar mushroom that, that isn't as good because it slows you down or something. Okay. Well, once my unicorn horn is charged, I'll come in here and just cheese a bunch of money out of that thing. Should be charged again by the time I get them on. Hi, Mom. Man, I've been playing with the sound off because when I play off stream, I usually listen to podcasts or something, and makes these rooms kind of annoying because I have no idea when the hands are going to drop. Oh, that is the one that slows me down. Okay. Oh God, shit! I shouldn't have tried to do that. Oh well. Well, there's something else for me to throw a bunch of money into. I should really wait until I see what's in the shop on this level before I start thinking of spending my money willy-nilly. Alright, speaking of willy-nilly money, let's pick that up. And let's go abuse one of those blood banks. Hey, see you, James Cantrell, what's up? Portable blood bank. How come that's what I always get? I never get the normal blood bank anymore. Oh well. I mean, the portable blood bank would be awesome if I had, like, the Habit and the Book of Revelation or, you know, one of those broken combos. My Two of Hearts card. Yeah, I won't be able to go back for it if I use the devil against Mom. I'm not sure which I'd rather... Oh God, I hate these guys. Not sure which I'd rather bring with me. Wait, are they trapped in... Oh, okay. They were trapped in there until I freed them. Alright, best thing to do against these guys, I found, is to just keep moving. Because if you stand still, they're probably more likely to spawn on top of you. Or I could just, like, stay in the middle here and wait for my bird to kill all of them. Okay, I got them. So I guess when they disappear and reappear, they're not actually teleporting. They're still moving, because otherwise they would have just, you know, teleported out of here. So I guess that's not how they work. Stand above a block. Yeah, that's true. I could have done that. Yeah, exactly. Habit plus Yum Heart. That's another good combo. That's one that makes your shots like... Well, no, that's just the normal mirror, isn't it? The one that makes your shots like kind of boomerang back at you. Oh no, that's the one. I thought the broken mirror might be something different. That's cool. I like this item, okay. Oh god, that was close. Man, those things are really scary. Especially when you can't just fly against the wall and shoot them from that position. These things shoot really fast. I don't like them. Also, they're like extra gross. Ah, crap. I don't know why I always get hit by this guy. He moves in such a predictable way. I guess I don't have good pattern recognition. Oops! Well, that's what I get for putting stuff on the shoulder buttons. Well, I have no idea what this is. Let's see what this pill is. Oh, that's the one that makes me lose hearts, but it spawns hearts as well. Let's go ahead and use that, I guess. See if it works out in my favor. It didn't really. Oh well. Well, let's see what it is. Broken watch. I think it's broken. No idea what that does. It's not a usable item. It's not a trinket. Well, I guess I'll find out. Maybe it'll like randomly freeze time or something. Or randomly freeze all the enemies. Shit. Oh, that's nice. Anything else on this floor I want to use a key on? Not really. Let's go for it. Cartridge. I remember these. Well, I do like my lockpick, even though it hasn't really done much yet. I think the lockpick makes the paperclip makes keys spawn more frequently. I haven't really seen it so far though, in this run. Well, no point in holding on to my money for the womb. Because the best thing I'll find is just another slot machine. Oh, it unlocks gold chest without a key? Really? Wow. That's pretty good. Oh yeah, I didn't lose my key when I opened that gold chest. Wow, that's pretty good. But I'll hold on to the cartridge just to see if I can figure out what it does. Alright, Mom. I'm coming for you. Oh god. Oh man, I should have gone and picked up that Two of Hearts. Oh well. Especially since I wasted my devil card. That's pretty unfortunate. Just Drop even told me not to forget about it. What do? I forget about it. It's not the most embarrassing mistake I've ever made in this game, but it's pretty high up there. HP and luck up. Okay. Oh, you don't take damage from walking into it? That's good. Okay. Well, I reckon I'm done here. Challenge room. Well, I do have this key. I'm probably not going to do anything else with, so might as well. Wait. Why am I slowing them? Oh, that must be the broken clock. Does it just slow every enemy in the room? Like, does it just... Yeah, because he was just automatically slow. Wow. That's pretty cool. I guess it only works twice a day. Get it? Three bosses? Unthinkable. Maybe it literally only works twice on every floor. That'd be pretty funny. Slows or speeds. Dang. I want to see what having all the enemies sped up would look like. Shit. I wonder if there's an icon for that one. I've heard so many people complaining about the music in this game, and I don't get it. I think it's great, and I think the original soundtrack was great. But you know, I already listened to the original soundtrack for 300 hours. You know, I much prefer having something different in this game. Well, I didn't listen to it for the whole 300 hours, but you know what I mean. I listened to it a lot. Oh, does the music slow down too? That's awesome. I like that a lot. Oh yeah, I can finally see what pheromones do. Yeah. Whenever I say what time my stream is going to be, I always use 24-hour time. Well, like I use 12-hour time for the Eastern time zone part. You know, just because that's what I'm used to. And then for UTC, I use 24-hour time, just because I figure if you're European, that's what you're probably using. I don't know. Do they use 24-hour time in Europe? I have no idea. I think when I took French class, like in 7th grade or something, when we learned the time, I thought we learned like 24-hour time. But maybe that's just France, because France has to do everything differently. Wait. Oh. I guess I'm not hurting them, except when they pop up like that. Oh good, another enemy you can only hit when it pops up. I mean, in a lot of ways, I think the 24-hour clock makes more sense. Because that way, you never run into situations where... Oh, I meant AM, but I set my alarm for PM by mistake. What a silly mistake. But, you know, a lot of stuff makes sense, but we still don't do it. Like, the metric system makes perfect sense. Using centigrade instead of Fahrenheit makes perfect sense. Water freezes at 0, boils at 100. Boom. Done. But, yeah, we, meaning Americans, are kind of stuck in our ways when it comes to units of measurement. Oh, they use 24-hour time in Germany. That's cool. I mean, I figured, you know, it would be favored by the same people who use the metric system in centigrade or Celsius for temperature, you know, would use the more sensible measure of time. I can't wait until we all move to metric time. That'll be pretty awesome. 10 hours in every day, 100 minutes in every hour. That wouldn't be hard to get used to at all. The thing this thing pops out of looks like that disgusting fish you always see pictures of on the internet. Like, I forget what it's called. The fish that looks kind of like a deflated Mr. Saturn. Okay, well, I'm at the boss. Trying to decide if there's anything I want to do. I mean, I guess I have 11 bombs. Well, I should save them just in case I end up fighting Satan. Daddy Longlegs. Haven't seen the Rebirth version of this guy yet. I wonder if the broken clock ever goes into effect during a boss fight. That would be awesome. Probably not. I got one of those. Whoa. Oh. Wait, that's not the unicorn horn, that's the Pac-Man thing. But I do have the unicorn horn as well. Oh! The Pac-Man thing must be because of the cartridge. I guess that just has a chance of happening when I get hit or something. I'm glad that happened because it reminded me I had the unicorn horn. And it made that boss fight way easier. Oh, it works in boss rooms, but not on the bosses. Yeah, that makes sense. I had an item that slowed the enemies down when I hit them, and that didn't work on the bosses. So, yeah. All right, down I go. Yes, the blobfish. Thank you, Lord Tamar. Yeah, Google blobfish if you want to see something kind of gross and funny. Well, has something to do with this money after all. Hey, whoa. Not cool, three-card Monty guy. Or shell game guy. Ooh. Not sure if I should pick that up or wait until I fight Mom's Heart. Because if I go to fight Satan, having that extra heart will definitely help. Can you believe I started this run with 0 actual hearts and now I have 7? That's fucking crazy. I found 7 health ups just in this run. Alright, well. Oh wait, that'll do a whole heart of damage to me, right? Yeah, okay. Well. Oh well. I'm back where I started. Oh yeah, I already picked Maggie up. With Maggie, you only have to have 7 hearts total, I think. Which means if you start as Isaac, you only have to get 4 during a run. So yeah, kind of crazy that I found this many. Hi, pills. Another pill that I haven't used yet. Oh, okay. I wish there was something more productive for me to do with all this money, but there really isn't. I'd love to just toss it all into a donation booth or something, or a donation box. Or get like power equals money, but I think you have to unlock that item. So I won't find it yet. Alright, I'm not going to spend too much more time in here, actually. Because I'm pretty good on bombs, definitely good on keys. Oh, you don't unlock her at 7 total? Oh, okay. They must have changed it then. Nice! I really like that snail icon. I don't know what it reminds me of, but it reminds me of something. I like these guys because they just kind of stay tethered to their wall. And just stay in the middle of the room and kill them. Oh, don't think I've seen the wall masters pop up in the womb yet. Just, holy crap, there's a lot of them. Just in the depths. Pheromones. Oh, might as well. Doesn't last very long. I like how it hits everything on the screen, though. That's pretty cool. Oh god! I wonder if pheromones work on the boss. Snail is from Earthbound. Oh, really? Oh god. Like, oh, everything's fast. Yep. The music changed. Oh shit. And these guys are already really fast. Tried to lay a bomb in a place they might go without... Shit. Without getting too close. Oh my god, these... Holy shit. This is really scary. I guess I could just like... Stay hovering over blocks. Play it as safe as possible. I guess it doesn't actually change the music. It just does that, like, that record scratch noise. Because it sounds the same. Who are you? And why did I get so uncomfortable looking at you? That is a very unsettling enemy design. Use the cheese. Oh. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you're right. Oh god. Should have paid more attention to those spider guys. Oh yeah, respawning poop. Man, having all the enemies sped up. That was no good. Especially since it was Dingle. I would like for that not to happen again. Oh, hey, a battery. What? Oh my god. I thought I killed everything, but I still got hit. Man, it'd be nice if I could just find the boss quickly. Oh god. There's some sort of magnetic thing in this room. Oh, Jesus. What the hell? What's that switch? Fuck! I forgot that the respawning poop actually hurts you. Oops, I don't want to restart. Well, Eden is definitely different every time, because now I have the shovel and a mohawk instead of spikes all over my head, and I start with a dead bird. Killed by poop, yeah, I know. Well, see what this item is. Maybe I will want to stay with this run. Yeah, I want to be someone different. So that's interesting. Just a, just a character that starts with different stuff every single time. Oh hey, Twisted Little Heart, what's up? Didn't notice you were here. Win streak minus two? Jeez. Does killing mom not count for anything? Oh, I unlocked Samson, so that's something at least. Oh, did they use my other Eden token because I restarted instead of coming back to the menu? That sucks. Wait, why do some of them have a little heart, like, over here? I wonder what that means. Maybe that means they start with an item? No, because Samson and Cain both start with items. Maybe it means I've used them before? But no, then there would be one for Isaac. Weird. Man, I unlocked Azazel in one of my other playthroughs, and I lost that save. That sucks. Oh, it means I beat Mom. Okay, that makes sense. Oh, her hit points is dependent on the items you start with. Okay. Well, I want to do a run through with Cain, because I haven't actually played with Cain yet. Moore's did, but not me. Yeah, I think I'm going to wait until, oh crap, what is that? It's not the soy milk, is it? Thunder thighs. I feel stompy. Oh. Oh, wow. I think I heard someone mention this item. It's like the nail gives you this ability too, but you only have that ability when you activate it, and it takes forever to recharge. With this, you just always have it. The chat room is very excited about this turn of events. Oh shit! I could just walk into the poop now. That's awesome. Oh yeah, I got Basement Boy. That was a very good run overall. I mean, Basement Boy was a very early part of it. Oh crap, get the mouse cursor off the screen. Alright, I think I'll save my key for now. Oh, Leo, the astrological sign. That's cool. I don't think I found that one yet. I can just get that shit without using a bomb? That is so awesome. Wow. Oh yeah, bomb rocks and mushrooms. Why do mushrooms hurt you when you stomp them? I have three keys now, so go ahead and grab this. That was well worth it. There are two locked doors. Wait. Oh, I guess I got another key. Okay, well, I have three keys, so I might as well... Whoa. What the hell? Is that a book that teaches me how to jump? It's like the Super Mario Brothers original box art. That's cool. Alright, so I have Judgment. That gives me the beggar guy and the tower, which is all the bombs. Oh, some mushrooms are poisonous. Okay. Well, this seems like a very interesting run so far. Okay, so that means this is the item room or the item shop. I guess I'll save that for now. save my money. Oop, shit. There we go, that's the button. Oop. Well, that was helpful. That is so cool. It's like the ladder, but way better. There's no recharge on it at all, or anything. So wait, why did that item give me the stompy ability? Oh, I guess it was like a bucket of fat or something, and I ate it, and now my thighs are fat. Hey, the box. I like the box. Gives you stuff. Alright, I got a broken magnet, a fool card, that pill. Alright, so use a fool card since I'm not going to take it with me. Get back here a little quicker. Whee! Grab judgment. Oh, I have 3 keys. I might as well see what's in the shop. It might be a good item that's on sale. Got keys out the wazoo here. Nice. A poor man's flying, yeah. Kinda. Because I can just go through blocks and I can jump over gaps. This changes everything. Oh, I guess I can't stomp that poop because it'll hurt me. I saw rainbow poop in one of my earlier playthroughs when I wasn't streaming. I can't tell if it did anything or not. It was like unicorn poop. Also, there are chests that are made out of stone, so you have to bomb them to open them. Oh yeah, it probably won't let you land in a gap. At least that's what I assume. I don't know. I'll try it when the opportunity comes up. Can't stomp these things though. They are unstompable. Health. Oh my god. Wait, I'm Kane. I'm not supposed to get bad pills. What the hell? Really? Did they nerf that? Because if they did, what's the point of even being Kane now? Oh, that is such a bummer. Maybe it's a glitch. Oh, Rainbow Poop heals you? Really? Man. That sucks. Kane's been reworked too. God, if they nerf that, I'll be so sad. That's the only reason to play Kane. You know you'll never have any bad pills. Whoa. It's like atomic tears. What the hell? Anti-gravity. What? Oh man. It's like the bubbler from Cave Story. It's exactly like that, because if you hold down the button long enough, then they just start flying. But if you let it go, they all fly out at once. Oh man. I don't know if I like that. Kane has been turned into the poop. Yeah, if he doesn't have that ability anymore. Oh, it's Hematemesis again. Well. We'll see what does it do when I only have 2 hearts. Okay, it takes one, spawns three. See, that's actually good. So I guess it takes half your hearts, and it spawns probably, like, between two and four. I'm not sure. Is reduced chance for negative pills now rather than none. Yeah, but I've gotten, like, multiple bad pills. Well, at least the enemies get hurt if they just walk into my tears. That's pretty cool. So for these guys who just follow me around, you can just kind of lay tears for them. Oh yeah, my half magnet. I wonder what only half works about it. Seems to be working okay. Maybe it's just certain items. Do not know how I feel about this item just yet. Ludovico combos with certain items in the way that I really want to experience myself. I saw someone play who got Ludovico plus Brimstone. And it was the most broken shit I've ever seen in my life. That was during an Ultra J-Man stream. He got that combo. Of course, the tears don't appear as fast as the bubbles with the bubbler. So it's not quite as good as that, because I really like the bubbler in Cave Story. But yeah, not sure how I feel. Well, I can go into the arcade, or I can spawn Judgment, or I can look for more secrets. I guess I don't have that many bombs, so I should probably save some of them. Yep, Brimstone definitely works with Ludovico. I don't even know what Ludovico does normally, because J-Man already had the Brimstone. Shit. Yeah, the tears always move in the direction you were facing when they spawn. Like, I can't do this and then look down to make all the tears fly down. Oh god. Shit, get away from me, you... Alright. 2 hit points. Should have been using my jump ability more to get away from that guy. I don't think I like the anti-gravity. Man, do I want to be Kane again? I mean... I have to deal with bad pills. What? Man, that is really, really sad. I mean, Kane was by far my favorite character in the original. Mom's wig. Oh. I have spiders that just appear. I wonder how many can be on the screen at once. I wonder if it's based on my shooting or if they just appear on their own. Nope. Seems to be based on my shooting. I wonder if they stick around from room to room. They do! Jesus. Well, I mean, I assume they disappear once they attack an enemy. Yeah. That's kind of cool, though. Having that many little critters running around for me. Yeah, I see what you mean, Twisted Little Heart. Like, I heard a lot of people say that they like the chocolate milk in the original game. And I hated it. I couldn't stand it. And I guess that's another taste thing. I did not enjoy the chocolate milk at all. Troll bomb, really? All it did was replace the bomb I used. What a crappy X-block. I like how in this game, those blocks look even less blue than they did in the original, but people still call them blue blocks. I mean, in the original, I can kind of see what they were getting at, but, yeah, it's not blue. Charge up a bunch of spiders before the boss. Yeah, I should. Seems to take time, though. I guess I should just always be shooting. Oh, crap. So more spiders will appear. I mean, I'm not going to do it during the stream, but at some point I want to just hold the button down for like as long as it takes and just see how many spiders I can get on the screen at once. But yeah, that would take forever and wouldn't be very interesting to watch. Just set something down on that button, leave the room, and come back. Jesus! The fool. And I'm already down to one heart. That sucks. Let's hold on to my key. Oh yeah. Alright, let's give it a little bit of time and just see how many spiders I can get crawling around. I'm not gonna do it for too long, but I want to see if there's like an obvious limit, like 8 spiders or something. Or wait, do I have to move around for them to spawn as well? Might be based on moving, not shooting. So let's see, I have 5. Maybe it's moving and shooting. Oh, maybe 5 is the max, actually. Yeah, I don't think I've had more than 5 at a time. Okay. Well, that's still pretty cool. I like it. Hi, Larry. Alright, spiders, you know what to do. Yes, do that. Do exactly that. I wonder what happens if you're flying, like, over a pit or something. I wonder if the spiders just don't spawn, or if they spawn, like, several inches away from you on solid ground. Because it would be pretty nice to just be able to hover over, like, a pit in certain rooms and just let spiders do all the dirty work for you. Of course, for any enemy that would work with, you could just hover over the pit and just shoot them, I guess. What? Oh, the belt, right? Speed up. Yeah, I agree, Twisted. The combos do seem to be much more tailored towards, like, you know, play the game the way you like to play it. Okay. I don't want to look for the secret room because I only have one bomb. Don't want to go to the item shop because I only have one key. I should have gone back to the menu and played as Maggie or someone instead of being Kane again. Oh well. It's weird that, like, on that screen. Ooh, that's a pretty good secret room. On that screen, the confirm button defaults to restart. Ooh, I like this guy a lot. I got him in one of my other runs. He picks up hearts laying around, and he drops soul hearts. But the rate at which he drops soul hearts is way more than the rate at which he picks up the hearts. So, it's a pretty good trade-off. Like, here, I'll let him pick that one up. And okay, he didn't drop anything for that one. But trust me, over time, the Dark Mom is well worth it. At least based on my previous experience. Man, it sucks that I died on the run that I had Thunder Thighs. That was a really cool item. Oh, can spiders? Oh yeah, I guess they can hurt flies. I thought they might not be able to since they're on the ground and everything. But no, they're fine. Dark Bomb, such a bro. Yeah, exactly. Alright, do I want to go to the arcade? No. Well, I guess I could since I have all this money. I don't know. Oh wait, what is this? Oh right, the fool. I mean, I don't want to go to the shop with the amount of money that I have. Or the amount of keys I have, rather. Oh, I can get into the item shop for free now if I want to. Two of clubs, double my bombs. Well, I would definitely come back for that. Oh. Thank you, friend. Alright, don't want to mess with either of these guys. I just want to grab that, I guess. Oh no, I want to go to the item room and then come back for that. Or item shop, rather. Oh, that's the Bible. Worked out well for us when I was playing with Moors. I think I might go ahead and pick that up. Temporary flight. There's an item that fills the screen with poop. Sounds pretty good. He said sarcastically. Alright, let's go back for the two of clubs. Hang on to it for when I have a few more bombs. Yeah, no point in taking the fool, really. Oh, the lucky poop, yeah, that would be pretty cool. The petrified poop. Didn't really seem to do that much for me when I had it, but I didn't keep it for that long. Alright, boss. Monstro. Why did you steal your name from a whale, Monstro? Couldn't think of your own name? Couldn't think of an original name? Are you that dumb? Come on, Spider, he's right there. I like it when he stomps on them and takes damage. He's so dumb. You're so dumb, Monstro. Why are you so dumb? Huh. He's not dropping those quite as fast as he was the last time I got him. Maybe they nerfed him or something. Because it was like, pick up one heart, drop two soul hearts. Like, not always. But pretty frequently, it felt like. Oh, two of spades, two of clubs. Well, I guess let's go ahead and use my two of clubs and take the two of spades with me, just in case. Oh man, I could get Spirit of the Night. Cost me two hearts, though. What's in here? Soul Converter. So that would let me convert my normal souls. Or my normal hearts into soul hearts. Don't think I'm gonna do that with the amount of health that I have. Okay, well, now that I have six bombs, let's poke around just a little bit. probably here, actually. I should have tried that first. Nope. Weird. It's probably not even worth doing this until I unlock more stuff. Man, I had no idea where it could be. I tried every location. Oh wait, I'm an idiot. I already got it. Wow. Man, glad nobody's watching this. Just kidding. Those of you that are here, thank you for watching. I'm sorry I'm dumb sometimes. See, on the original map, the secret room was like a different color. Or it was like black with a question mark. And on this map, the secret room is just a normal colored room with a question mark. So, you see why I was confused. I was looking for the black spot on the map. Oh yeah, one regular heart for 3 soul hearts. This looks like, looks familiar. Gimpy. Oh, I thought it was like a robot head. Well, that's not what I was expecting. What does it do? The description text said sweet suffering. Rosary bead, faith up. Nice. I think you guys might be way behind me. Seems like there's a lot of lag. Because I was talking about Guppy's Paw quite a while ago. Maybe this does something when I get hit. I didn't see... Shit! Anything happen. I have no idea. Let's take out this fire first of all. Get that threat out of the way as fast as possible. Or deal with the threat that I can take out the most quickly first. Actually, all this fire should go. Crap! Oh, getting hit might drop a soul heart. Interesting. Thanks, Twisted. Oh, that's that switch I saw in the other room. I never picked that up because I died first. I didn't realize it was a trinket. Guess it makes sense though, because what else could it have been? Hi, fellas. Why are my spiders not spawning? Can I just not see them because it's too dark? Or maybe they don't spawn in challenge rooms? That'd be kind of a weird... caveat? Just trying to think of the word. Wait, there was a... There they are. Maybe they just don't spawn. Well, no, because they spawn even when there are no enemies in the room. Weird. Alright. Broken remote. It's broken. Or callus. My feet feel stronger. Alright, so this doesn't... Oh, maybe this protects me from, like, spike damage or something. That'd be cool. I don't know what the broken remote does. If it's like the doctor's remote, that means like missiles will randomly fall from the sky. If it's like the other remote, it means I will randomly teleport. I think I'll go with the callus, actually. See if, oh, Twitch is being terrible, hyper lag. That sucks. Oh, I can just walk on this stuff. Nice. I wonder if it's just that stuff or if it spikes too. Stay away from me. There are items in Rebirth now that makes it so you drop that trail of blood. And it's pretty cool. It's like, hey, tables have turned. You don't see those jumpy spiders too often in Rebirth. I hardly ever see them. Oh, any ground effects, says Lord Tamar. Awesome. Oh god. Okay. Just these guys. They're better than the blood vomit spiders. Alright, I have 3 keys, and I already got the item room on this level. So, I guess I should see what these doors are. Alright, I can buy a deck of cards, which I'd rather have the Bible. Even though I haven't used I haven't used it yet. I would like to hang on to it. Wait. Yes, Book of Revelations. Excellent. Sorry, Bible. Oh yeah. That's not the item button. You know, eventually, I'll learn my buttons on the controller. I mean, I might as well. Wait. Wait, holy... Did I always have that many soul hearts? I thought the Book of Revelation just spawned a soul heart that you can pick up. Did it just give it to me, or did it give me more than one? I didn't think I had that many soul hearts. Oh wait, maybe it did give it to you in the original. I might be thinking something else that spawns them. Speed up, nice. Well, I guess my mask has probably been generating a few soul hearts. God, I'm really fast now, Jesus. My stat isn't even that high. Alright, so what was I... Oh yeah, the rosary bead. I was down in this bottom right-hand corner room. Alright, I'm gonna hang on to my 2 of spades. Meh. Wait, I wonder if Cain still has really good luck with these. Because in the original Isaac, he got something from these machines like every single time. Sure what it looks like. Yep, every single time. Well, I'm all full up on soul hearts now. Oh, by the way, in this version, 12 is the maximum. In the original Isaac, your health kept going, even though it couldn't appear on the screen. In this version, there's a heart cap. Like, if I spawn another soul heart... Oh, well, maybe it's not every single time, but it's pretty close. If I spawn another soul heart, I probably won't be able to pick it up. Or it'll just keep giving me cards. Yep, cannot pick that up because I have 12. Ooh, the stars. Well, check out the... Oh, right, the item room. Damn it. I thought I got it mixed up with the moon. I always do. Yeah, that's true, Twisted. Some of the speed upgrades. It's one of the darkest things about this game. I think I'll hang on to the 2 spades. Well, I guess I can just use it. You get 4 keys. So I can take the Hierophant with me. Or the Chariot. I'll take the Hierophant. More health where the possibility of more health is always good. Alright, I'm done on this level. I'm taking way too long. Agonizing over my decisions. Of course, I had the Book of Revelation, so... it's not like... I don't have a steady source of soul hearts. Alright, I'm out of here. Okay, so I guess there's still a reason to use Kane with the slot machines and stuff. But man, the pill thing still bums me out. Come on. Say ah, thank you. Oh, it's one of these rooms. Okay, I need to figure out how this works. So last time it was a... Okay. So it works when you just walk onto the die. Apparently. Last time it was a 4. And there was like an item in the middle of the room. And I thought picking something up made it reroll. But I guess it's just walking onto the die. Because that happened when I walked onto it. I found pills. Okay. I wasn't sure if I could get that without taking damage or not. I mean, I have all this health. I guess I might as well see what's in here. Oh, it's one of those, it's one of those stone chests. It's really weird. Guppy's head, reusable fly hive. Well, that's cool. Not as cool as the Book of Revelations, though. Paralysis. Okay. Well, that other paralysis can just stay there, I guess. The number dictates what it will do. Yeah, I figured that. But I have no idea, like, what the difference between a 3 and a 4 would be. I mean, I guess... maybe the higher the number is, like, the better the stuff you get. Because with 3, I didn't get an activated item. I just got pickups. And then 4 had an activated item. Ringworm. Holy shit. Oh man, that's weird. I think I'll hang on to the callus though. Like, that's a really powerful trinket. For, you know, not being, like, an activated item or something. It's just always on, and it protects you from spikes. Oh yeah, I was protected from spikes. I totally forgot about that when I was freaking out about not stepping on them. So yeah, even though I forgot about it, it's a very powerful trinket. I mean, God, between my dark bum friend, the gimp mask, and the Book of Revelation, I'm just a walking soul heart machine. A walking soul heart factory. Haha, you don't hurt me, Spikes. Suck it. Oh, I see. So the higher the number is, the more stuff it rerolls. Gotcha. Yeah, the wave beam was kind of cool. I don't know. I like the callus too much to give it up just yet. It's a $1 million idea, if Edmund McMillan, if you're watching this. Make little plush versions of those tiny poops with the big smile and everything, and make it have a squeak box inside, so when you squeeze it, it makes that eep noise. Just sell 50 bajillion of them. Well, That might be a slight exaggeration, but I'll buy one. Yeah, that would be amazing, Twisted. Of course, it seems like the dice rooms are really rare, and it seems like getting a 6 would be, like, extremely uncommon. So yeah, you'd have to be really lucky to be in a situation where you get a 6 and it helps you. Well, since I have all these soul hearts, what I could do is use this, get myself down to 1 heart, and go do that boss challenge room. I think I'll do that. Well, if it doesn't blow up before then. Ideally, I'd be lucky enough to get the blood bag or something. Alright, well, that's good enough for now. Oh yeah, I need to remember that. Thank you, Lord Tamar. I mean, there's no point in using my Book of Revelation now, because I have so many soul hearts. Wow! That was shit. Come on, game. I expect better stuff from the boss challenge rooms. I mean, the normal challenge rooms, okay, I get it. You don't have to give me something amazing every single time because there's just 3 waves of enemies. But come on, this is... Not only do I have to get myself down to 1 heart to use it, I have to fight multiple bosses. And you give me 2 troll bombs and a soul heart. Of course, there's still the... Still, whatever I get when I actually clear it, but I doubt it'll be worth it because that's never like a pickup, or it's never like an activated item. It's always just like a heart or a key or something. Oh, hi, Peep. Yeah, feel free to pee all over the floor. But you never thought you'd hear me say that, huh? Well. In previous games, when I was flying, you might hear me say it. But now, even though I'm not flying, I can still walk on your pee with impunity. I mean, I guess I shouldn't be volunteering to walk on pee or anything, because even though it doesn't hurt me, it's still pretty gross. Hey coach, how's it going? I just walked on pee. How's it going with you? Ah shit. I might have butchered that quote. God damn it. Freaking eyeballs. Eyeballs OP. I get it. OP. Because it's peep. Shit. I mean, I still, overall, only took 1 soul heart of damage in that. Boss challenge runes have been nerfed. Sure what it looks like. Oh. Yeah, I've already been in there. That pill is just a paralysis or something. Well, so far the astrological signs have all been pretty good. Libra, I feel balanced. What does that mean? Did it balance out all my stats? No? Huh. Well. Didn't balance my items. I still have... equal number of, or the same number of those that I had. It would have been cool if it, like, added my money, my bombs, and my keys, and divided by 3, and just set them all to that number. Didn't balance my health, really. I don't know what it did. Stay away from me. God damn it. Supposedly balances your stats. Doesn't look like it. I wonder if there's a different pickup for all of the astrological signs. Because I have a hard enough time keeping the 12 tarot cards separate. Having to remember what the 12 different signs do. That would be a pain in the ass. Okay, well, this is going to be a double boss, it looks like, because that's an elongated room. So, let's get ready. Oh yeah. Holy crap, I'm seeing double here. 4 Geminis. Get it? Because Gemini already means there's 2 of them. And it's like that Simpsons quote. I like the double bosses. It's pretty fun when you have all this room to run around in. Yeah, I guess I might as well use my Book of Revelation since I'm down. Oops. Oh, okay, good. It still recharged it for this room, even though I triggered it kind of the last minute there. I'm a lot slower than I was before, am I? Oh man, the game likes me tonight. Holy crap. Alright. Anything else I want to do here? I mean, I do have 9 keys, so. And I have 36 coins. This is the item shop over here, right? I don't know why I didn't go in it to begin with. Ooh, the piggy bank. Kinda thinking I just wanna dump all my money into this. Or as much money as it'll take anyway. I wanna get whatever the upgrades this thing offers. Oh man, it keeps... Shit, well, might as well get the piggy bank. No point in charging my book up immediately, really. Oh, are you talking about, like, how half my face is... like black now from the astrological sign I picked up. I could keep trying for the blood bag, but I think I'm good. Goog Grail. Oh, thank you, Twisted. Very nice of you to say. Well, I might come back to you. Oh, crap. Oh, shit. I still got hit by it. Fudge! Man, the hitbox on that thing is like... I don't know. Gotta be careful. Hey, Wrath. Boy, you sure like getting hit by your own bombs, huh? Paralysis? No thanks. Why did it spawn a soul heart just now? That's weird. It spawns hearts for weird reasons in this game. Reusable bomb, that's okay. I'll keep my Book of Revelations, thanks. Don't need the callus anymore. Oh yeah, that's true. If I find another trinket, I'll go ahead and pick it up. Okay. Wonder if I could just, like, not release them and just kind of... No. I'll end up hitting the poop. Oh well. I will free you from your pooply prison. I mean, it's kind of messed up when you think about it. Trapping a poop in poop. Be like building a prison out of other people. And trapping a person in it. Like a prison of corpses. Oh man, you charge now. I didn't notice that. I mean, it makes sense because he spawns these charging maggots when he dies. Yeah, I haven't unlocked Judas yet. Judas was always my least favorite character in the original. So, even when I do unlock him, I doubt I'll be using him that much. It didn't say what the unlock requirements for Judas are, did it? I don't remember. I'll have to check the, check that screen after this run. I don't think the other poops are cute, just the tiny little ones. Like the ones with the weird toothy smiles, I don't like that much. A sperm. Oh no, E. coli. Oh yeah, that's right. It's the one that turns enemies into poop. Okay. Well. Not the best item ever, but I'll take it. Alright, I want to look around for the item shop, because I do have quite a few coins. Yeah, prison made of corpses does kind of sound like a Silent Hill thing. What's this big key do? Less is now more, plus two keys. Have I gotten that one before? That sounds familiar. I don't know what that means. Less is now more. Maybe... I have no idea. Shit. Wait, E. coli doesn't give me the poop bombs, does it? No, that was something else. Melt Man with the power to melts. USOB. USOB. Yeah, I don't understand why that soul heart just spawned. If that was the one that spawned from me getting hit, it came a little late. I guess I can go ahead and use the book now. Bad trip. Explosive diarrhea. Great. I don't remember if either of those actually count as bad pills. I think Kane might have been able to get those before. Action League now, yeah. On Kablam. It wasn't my favorite Kablam segment, but it was a pretty good one. Oh, I have 9 keys. I already got the shop and the item room. Okay. What's this guy going to do with these keys? Oops. Oh, well, I guess I need those anyway. Like, I can understand begging for money, and I can understand a demon begging for blood. I don't know what this guy is. Oh, hey. I got a bunch of guppy items. I got Guppy's collar when I was playing solo. Oh, yeah, I'm Guppy now. Awesome. And I couldn't figure out what it did. It said eternal life question mark. And it says times one up there, like I might have extra lives. But the last time I had Guppy's collar, I just ended up dying normally. So I'm not sure what it does. Maybe it gives you like a random number of extra lives or something. Well, all that, and it still just gave me the paperclip. Well, I'll take it, because obviously I don't need the callus anymore. Melts the keys down and makes dimes. Yeah, maybe. Well, I used most of my keys to get all that, but I got a bunch of chivos, so I guess it was worth it in the end. Oh shit, fuck you. This probably won't be worth it, but oh well. I mean, would have been worth it if I needed those. I should not be so cocky. Yes, I have a lot of soul hearts. It does not mean I'm going to win the game. It does not mean I'm going to be able to kill Satan. You know, I like having all these soul hearts now, but once the game starts getting brutal, they might not be enough to save me. Oh, Guppy is strong as fuck. Does that increase my stats or something? I never really knew what Guppy did, like even in the original. I want to try something, just out of curiosity. Oh, okay. I thought maybe. Well, no, because there would be no way to get to that. Okay. This looks promising, though. Yeah. Oh. Okay. There was a blood skull under this skull, but it went away when I left the room. Oh, Guppy spawns flies with tears. Oh, I see. Yeah, that makes sense because Guppy's head, I think, has that ability as an activated item. Alright, let's go. The Hollow. Two of them. Nice. Or four of them. Seems a little tame for a depths boss. Wow, that is a lot of flies. That is really cool. HP up, I'll take it. I got this guy in a previous run. He was pretty cool. He's like a familiar that shoots flies. I always forget what this thing does. I think I'll try it. Oh, yeah. Lord of the Pit. Oh, okay. Yeah, I always get Lord of the Pit and Spirit of the Night mixed up because they're both Magic the Gathering demon enemies. So, yeah, I don't know if that does anything for me other than give me wings, which I already have. So, that might have been a waste. But I mean, I have all of these soul hearts generating all the time, so I feel like I'll be okay. I just have a swarm of spiders and flies following me. This is awesome. Oh yeah, I could have if I wanted to guarantee Shale. Oh well. Sure, I'll buy another key. Why not? And I guess that's it. I'll just get out of here. I don't know. I haven't beaten Satan yet, so I'm not sure if I want to guarantee Shale. I mean, I don't think having a winning streak does anything for me. It's just like bragging rights, but it's kind of a bummer always going to that screen and seeing like minus 2 or minus 3 win on my win streak. Because I think I get the Eden token just for killing Mom's heart. I don't think I actually have to win the run to get that. Pheromones. Or pheromones. I think I always mispronounce that word. Ooh, I don't know if I want that. I kind of like my fire eating stuff. Minus 26? Holy shit. Yeah, that's true. I could have had a bigger fly army. What do you guys think? Should I take the Polyphemus thing or not? I mean, with my fire rate, it would be really slow, not much fun to use. I think I'll leave it alone, unless everyone in the chat really wants me to take it. Yeah, having Guppy is really, really good in this. I think I got the couple times I got Guppy in the original Binding of Isaac, I don't think I was blown away. I was like, I had to collect all this stuff to unlock this, and it didn't seem to do much for it. The damage in the situation, or the damage is awesome. Poly in the situation is hard. Yeah. Because I think fewer flies would spawn. I think Twisted Little Heart is right. Well, not even going to try for that boss challenge room because it has not been worth it so far. Don't want to deliberately. Well, unless there's a blood machine, I wouldn't be able to, really. Because I'd have to lose all these soul hearts, and I'm not going to do that. Yeah, I got the contact shot in the solar run. That item was really cool. I liked it a lot. God, these flies are awesome. This whole build is awesome. Plenty of bombs, if I do make it to Satan. Of course, I had plenty of bombs last time, and I still died. Let's go up first. Save the big room. Two keys? Sure, I'll do it. Monkey paw, still haven't figured out what that does. Oh, I don't have anything to replace this with. Well, I just went ahead and use it. Get it out of my inventory so I don't accidentally hit it. Eh. Oh well. Thought I'd try. Oh god. Multiple pins. Three of them. Holy cow. Frame rate on them seems to be dipping a little bit. I guess because there's so many of them on the screen. Alright, I'm full up. Okay. Okay, so what's this? Item shop? Yeah. Well, don't know what this cord thingy does. Charged with blood. Oh, so my, maybe it's like the habit where my item charges some when I get hit? I'm not sure. Nah, no reason to buy that key, really. Alright, Mom. Prepare to be assaulted by flies and spiders. Jesus Christ, God, her foot comes down so quickly now. Like, there's barely any delay between the shadow showing up and the foot coming down. Or maybe the shadow is just harder to see, so I don't see it until it gets bigger. Shit! God damn it, I saw it, and I still couldn't get it out of the way. Mom's contact. Nice. Okay. What you got for me, Satan? I don't think I need that, really. But thanks anyway. Go ahead and use that since... What? Oh. I guess I hit the bomb button by mistake. Beats the game up until Mom in a timely fashion. Like, how timely? Like, how quickly would I have to do it? Because this isn't the kind of game I like to rush. Shit. Okay. Thanks. Really? Oh, fuck. Okay. You're so hard for me, huh? You're not pulling your weight, Dark Bomb friend. I wonder if there's a Key Bomb friend as well. Who just picks up keys and gives you stuff. Oh, 20 minutes to be Mom? Yeah, that's not happening. Especially not if I'm streaming, because I like to, I like to stop and think about things out loud. I like to think that's what makes it interesting. Well, found the boss quickly. That's a good sign. Go ahead and use that. Yep. Death. Not seeing the horsemen quite as frequently as I used to. Wait, can I kill the scepters or the scythes now? Used to not be able to kill them, I think. Yeah, I can totally kill them. That's pretty cool. Oh shit. Oh, I guess they're not spawning that frequently because I'm not using the Book of Revelation that much. Because when you use the Book of Revelation, it, like, guarantees a horseman boss. And I haven't been using it because I've been full up on soul hearts. Right, so that's the bandage ball. Kind of circles around you just like Meat Boy. Or the the cube of meat, excuse me. I have to take a drink of water. Okay, let's pick a direction. Hi, Doppel. Or Doppel. God, look at that. Look at all those flies. That's absurd. Sick 'em. Kind of ironic. Well, I guess it's not ironic. It's exactly what you would expect. Poop being attacked by flies. Because, you know, that's what they do. They go after poop with reckless abandon. Come on, buddy. Eat up. Okay. The new style of death. What, like the way he's designed or the way, like the mechanics of him? Hey, fall in that pit. Or just die. Do that. The world? Well, might as well use that so I know exactly where the boss is. Or I could save it for Shale. I think I'll save it just in case Shale is a thing on this run. I mean, I'm not taking any heart damage. And that's the thing that makes a devil room likely to appear, right? Not taking heart damage, or not taking damage from my red hearts. So, I'd say my chances are probably pretty good. Oops, oh. God, look at all the mini Gerties. Eat up, friend. Alright, I want to go back and get that soul heart. Okay. Oops. Oh, hey, nice. Glad I saved that card. Okay. Oh, the way he looks bothers you. Huh. Alright, I guess there's no point in wasting time. Of course, I have to continue not taking red heart damage for the duration of this fight. If I want my chances to be as good as possible. Shit. Which, I mean, you know, I have soul hearts spawning occasionally when I get hit, so that'll help me out. Plus, I still have my book. I can pop that now if I want to. I have my bone friend picking up hearts. Oh, shit. Oh god. Alright. Oh, I guess I had an achievement for having a bunch of stuff floating around me. Solar system. Yeah, me too, Twisted. That fight is way better than it was in vanilla. Or in the original. Alright. This is probably the best possible circumstances in which I can be fighting Satan. Oh, that's a challenge. Okay. I thought it was an unlock. Alright. Don't get cocky. Oh. Bad trip. Okay. Well, save that in case I get knocked down to one heart. Give myself full health. See what's in here. Great. God. Those secret rooms are so terrible now. Solar system challenge is a thing? Really? Hey, check out the Triforce scrawled on the floor in blood. That's a loving tribute. I mean, really, it's just a Sierpinski triangle. I don't like these ghosts one bit. They remind me of the wizard robes from Zelda, and I hated those as well. Oh shit. God. Well. Quite a bit of damage there. Let me go back for the soul heart. Oh god, where are these heads? Oh, Jesus. Okay, well. At least they're predictable. I just can't go to that part of the screen. Man, imagine if the way these were arranged wasn't so easy to avoid. Imagine if they were like staggered throughout the room. That would be the worst. Oh god. God damn it. Oh man, this is just me playing bad. This isn't even Mysterious Candy. Don't think I ever figured out what that did. God, I'm down to one soul heart. How am I so bad? Oh, they reminded you of wizard robes too. Yeah, they suck. Holy shit, I have a lot of money. My kingdom for a donation booth. Alright, well, here goes. I have 30 bombs, which means I can probably use some on the lesser forms of Satan. Because I won't need that many for the third form. I'll need some bombs, but not necessarily that many. Shit. I mean, you have to remember, before I started playing Rebirth, I hadn't played the Binding of Isaac seriously in a very long time. So my skills gotten a tad rusty. Shit. Alright, full health. Actually, I remembered to use it this time. Unlike when I was playing with Morse. Alright. Shit. I mean, you can't see the shadows in this version of the room at all. Like, it's way too dark to see them. No! I had him. Satan was exploding into blood. I had him. Hey, making that face doesn't make someone a weeaboo twisted. It's just a cat face. Doesn't have anything to do with anime necessarily. Son of a... Well, three mom heart kills. There's a little X on there for every kill. Yeah, it doesn't even say what you have to do to unlock Judas in this one. I have an Eden token, win streak minus 4. Alright, well, I guess that'll about do it. Sorry for not being clutch. But hey, it'll just make victory that much sweeter when we finally achieve it. Or when I finally achieve it. But yeah, thanks everyone so much for coming out and watching. As always, it was a blast. And I'll do this again sometime soon. And maybe we'll be streaming the new Borderlands game this Sunday. I'm not sure. But yeah, thanks everyone, and I will see you soon. Goodbye.